This is a kalliroscope, a shallow, transparent container filled with rheoscopic fluid, which is a fancy name for water filled with a little powdered mica. The flat pieces of mica align themselves in the direction of local fluid motion and make it easy to see currents and eddies. Kalliroscopes were invented in the late 1960s by Paul Matisse, the grandson of the great French master Henri Matisse. Paul Matisse's originals can sell for thousands of dollars if you can find them at all. Even new small knockoffs like this can run over $100. Fortunately, they can be made at home for as little as $10. Here's how. I started with this container I got from Walmart and used the top to create a small round one and cut the bottom off to create this one. Next, I cut plexiglass pieces to act as the windows and glued them to the bases using aquarium sealant. This will take 2 days to fully cure. Lastly, I cut small holes for corks in the base of each one. And after filling with the fluid in each case, I used more of the aquarium sealant to secure the corks in place so they didn't come out. Before filling with the rheostatic fluid, I colored it, in this case orange, in this case blue. And what I found is that darker colors, like green and blue, show a lot more motion and are more interesting to watch than the lighter colors, like this orange or pink. And that was it. Well, not quite. It turns out these didn't work very well. One problem was that these small containers have a very high ratio of inside surface area to volume of fluid. And what that means is there's a lot of drag, which quickly slows the fluid motion. And after just a few seconds, or maybe a minute if you're lucky, it pretty much stops and it's not very interesting to watch. Another problem was the placement and size of the little corks. These didn't hold very well, as you can see, they're leaking. And placing them on the bottom meant you couldn't really spin these because it would tear the corks out and create a mess. Still another problem is that, if you can see it, there's a lot of bubbles in there. And although I bled out as many as I could, once I'd sealed it up, more bubbles appeared. It turns out that air dissolves into the liquid, and after you contain it, it comes out on the surface and you get these bubbles, which just don't look very good. I need to find a way to get rid of them. Finally, the rheoscopic fluid that you can buy online is pretty expensive. A 1 liter bottle like this is $26-$27 from Amazon. And this is fine if you're only going to build one or two, but if you want to build more or larger ones, this stuff just gets too expensive. To address these problems, I've already started 2 follow-on videos. One about how to make the best and cheapest rheostatic fluid that shows more motion and keeps in motion longer, and a second on how to make better kalliroscopes. Until they get posted, if you want more nerdy techie articles like this one, try my main website at waynesthisandthat.com, where you'll find 539 pages covering all sorts of similar projects. Everything from why Winogreen lifesavers flash blue when crushed to the oddity of Fletchner colors. And as always, thanks for watching.